it's actually just like, it's from the heart. You see, this is like, if you look at this situation, this is what can be done, this is what can't be done, etc., etc. Without, and with, you know, with the use of poetry, instead of, you know, like new metal bands like shouting at you. Yeah. We don't do that. It's like, it's much more earth orientated, if you know what I mean. Earthy sounds, very acoustic, very violin based, and so it's like a lot of pretty melody as well as truisms.
I think maybe one really good example about that point is like Confess, the third song on the record. Mm. Is that right? Because that's a really serious song.
It's a very serious song, yeah. It's about degradation, the degradation of the soul, the degradation of your own soul. I mean, having said, I know I lived in Amsterdam a long time ago, but no, I see Amsterdam now, and I see, you know, you go around the red light district, etc., etc.
See difference from then and now?
No, it's exactly the same. It hasn't changed at all. It's still filthy. But it's degradation of the soul, and it's like, do you want to do that? Do you accept that as a person yourself? And if you do go down that road, what do you make of it? And that's, you know, it's because everybody's interested in their dark side, and that's what that song's about.
Okay.
Confronting your own dark side.
Yeah, the first single of the record is Make You Happy. That's a really happy song. Is that also the intention?
It's a kind of strange song because it's actually, I'd love to make you happy, but the second line is, but I'm busy.
Yeah, with not
my,
now.
With my mind, I'd love to, but I'm really actually a bit busy because I'm caught up in my own life. And I think it's true of everybody. Everybody would love
to make someone happy.
To make everybody happy, but they're also busy, caught up in the machine that is their life.
You know? Do you think that people are really selfish lately?
I think people are increasingly selfish, yeah, and that's pretty much what that song's about.
Why then? Is it like because there are so many people fear in the world or whatever?
It's fear. It's fear.
Why fear?
Fear of...
Is it lack of time?
No, it's basically fear. It's fear engendered by governments and media to make you feel that you shouldn't socialise together. You must all stay at home and make money and make children and work for the society rather than actually gathering together and going, hang on a minute, yeah. We're all being had here. There's no such thing as terrorism, and there's no such thing as this, and there's no such thing as that. You know, of course, there are a few things, but like, essentially, you know, the weight, the media weight and the government pressure is far outweighs the actual reality of what our actual lives are actually like, but people live in fear.
Do you think so?
I do, yeah. Generally speaking, if you talk to most people,
but what they are afraid of then, like not being satisfied, not being really good.
They're terrified of everything, pretty much. So they're scared of each other because they're told not to spend time together. They're told, you know, work, pay, earn money, pay your rent, pay your mortgage. Don't hang out together. Don't party because one day you'll grow old and you'll have no money. Or, you know, if you don't pay attention, if you travel the world too much, you might die because a terrorist might kill you. All these sort of things. It's like absolute fucking nonsense.
How do you know that? Like, do you talk to people and they talk? Do you read about it?
I read a lot of newspapers. I'm well informed. I like to be well informed. I watch a lot of news. I listen to a lot of news radio in the UK. And I look at the internet and it's like, hang on a minute. Come on. Yeah, yeah. Everybody is being forced into a situation because it's very convenient for governments to have people just doing and towing the line.
That's right.
And if you're doing anything else other than that, then it's a real inconvenience to them. They don't want that.
Yeah. You know what happened here, like in 2002, the euro came in. Mm. So everything, we had a guilder, it was like one guilder is like 50 euro cents.
Yeah.
And now it's like,
I know.
A beer is 2 euros.
I've just been finding,
and it was like one of maybe two guilders, like half.
I know, I've just been finding out how much more expensive it is out here now. It's unbelievable. I've just spent a week in Berlin on holiday on my own.
So you've seen it?
And I've seen it in Berlin. And Berlin, we've got 19% unemployment, and it's like £3.20 for a pint.
Jesus
Christ. That's just incredible, which is like, I don't know how many euros it is, but it's a lot.
Yeah.
About the same, a bit less.
But it's the same price as Amsterdam, yeah. And it's just too much, you know. And people in Berlin, they're skint. Do you know what?
Nobody protests,
because they're not allowed to.
Yeah, no, we can go on the street like we don't want it.
I was in a riot in Kreuzberg on the May 1st, the traditional Kreuzberg riot.
Oh, I've seen that, yeah.
Yeah,
like,
yeah.
World Labor Day or something?
Yeah, Labor Day, yeah. Right. Yeah, I was in that. Hence this on my head.
Ah, Jesus, what happened then?
I got hit.
By a cop?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. Were you like protesting there?
No, I was just joining in. I thought it was fun.
Yeah, but you were there for holiday, just for holiday?
Yeah, I was just there for holiday. It was coincidence that I was there, and I ended up in Kreuzberg. But it was it's a set piece riot. The police do it, and the police show up, and they know there's going to be a riot, and it has to happen. At 8 o'clock, it's like, all right, it's time to start shouting at each other and throwing stuff.
No way.
Yeah, really, set piece, proper set piece, and then by midnight, it's all finished. Everyone goes home. I went back the next day to go and find my bicycle. It was like nothing had ever happened.
No way.
Really, unbelievable. That's spotless. Strange. It's really strange. That's the Germans, though. They like that sort of thing. Very, very efficient.
Damn, okay. What about the interview generation? What do you think? Because they are being told, the kids are being told, like, when they see progress as cribs, for instance, like, people have the biggest houses, biggest cars ever.
Yeah. Well, you know,
is that also, like, getting in their head? Like,
I think rap music, right? I think rap music's been the biggest letdown, cultural letdown, ever, right? Because rap music is a platform to actually give people the right information. Instead, what they're doing is giving people aspirations they cannot ever hope to achieve.
Right.
They cannot ever hope to drive around in a big fucking car with a big fucking load of posse, with a load of fucking guns, and a load of fucking babes. Going back to the big fucking house, smoking loads of cocaine, and living a big fucking pop star lifestyle.
Live for 2 years and then die, bro.
It's not going to happen, and it's bullshit, because rap music, when it first came out, was to tell people how it is and how we can change shit.
No, is it a sellout, do you think?
It's a complete sellout. I think it's a fucking disgrace.
It's all about babes and snow.
It's a fucking disgrace. It's appalling. It appalls me. I can't stand it.
Okay, but the kids really don't want to work like in the lower class anymore in a shop.
Because they've been told that they can have this.
It can be faster.
They can have this by fucking being able to learn to rhyme quickly. They can have this. It's bollocks. You can't. You have to fucking really apply yourself and change the world properly, not fucking through... I hate it. Quite clearly, you know I hate it.
Yeah.
But, like, you know, Public Enemy, that was proper. You know, that was desperate, political. And it's, you know, it's a spoken word. And it's very spoken. There's no melody in it. So you might as well say something fucking useful instead of saying, I've got this and I've got
my candy shop, I'll lick your lollipop.
Yeah. I make porn movies, you can come too. So fuck off. Hate it.
Okay.
Still, the videos look good, though.
Late in the evening, most of them.
Yeah.
Okay, some more songs. New single's coming out. Is it already out? Make You Happy?
It is already out, yeah.
How was the first received in England? Because I think it's
good. It did. We went into the top four.